Hello students, myself Dr. Sheetal Kulkarni and I am going to teach you biomedical instrumentation. In that, the first unit topic is biopotential and their measurement, which includes structure of cell and cell component functions. Let us revise about prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Cell is a compartment where all the activities of life takes place. There are two basic types of cells in nature. Those are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic are the simplest cell without a nucleus and cell organelles. Prokaryotic cells are the smallest cells of size 1 to 5 micrometer. Their organization is unicellular. DNA is of circular type. Cytoplasmic structure available in very few structure. The typical organisms are bacteria and archaea. Eukaryotes are sophisticated cells with a well-defined nucleus and cell organelles. The cells are comparatively larger in size, nearly 10 to 100 micrometer. They are in unicellular to multicellular in nature. They are available in colonies, higher multicellular organisms with specialized cells. Their DNA molecules are linear molecules. Cytoplasmic structure is highly structured by endomembranes and a cytoskeleton. Typical organisms are fungi, algae, plants and animals. Size ranges from tiny yeast to giant dinosaurs, etc. The main distinguished feature of eukaryotes is compartmentalization. The presence of membrane-bound organelles in which the specific activity takes place. Here I have shown you the diagram of cell. It includes different cell components such as mitochondria, plasma membrane, microtubule, centrosome, microfilament, lysosome, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, secretory vesicle, peroxisome, vacuole, cytoplasm, Golgi vessel, Golgi apparatus, chromatin, nucleolus, nucleus, rough endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, intermediate filament, etc. Let us see in detail about the cell structure. Cells are the basic building blocks of all living things. The human body is composed of trillions of cells. They provide structure for the body, take in nutrients from food, convert those nutrients into energy, and carry out specialized functions. Cells also contain the body's hereditary material and can make copies of themselves. Cells have many parts, each with a different function. Some of these parts, called organelles, are specialized structures that perform certain tasks within the cell. A group of cells form tissue, various tissues form an organ, and different organs make up the body. Human cells contain the following major parts. Listed here, let us see their location and functions. The first one is cell membrane. Thin layer of protein and fat that surrounds the cell is the cell membrane. It is semi-permeable, allowing some substances to pass into the cell and blocking others. Cytoplasm. Within the cells, the cytoplasm is made up of jelly-like fluid called the cytosol and the other structures that around the nucleus. It is the site of protein synthesis and many metabolic events. The cytoplasm contains many enzymes for general metabolism. It contains fiber of the cytoskeletal systems which organize cytoplasmic structure. Cytoskeleton is a network of long fibers that make up the cell structural framework. The cytoskeleton has several critical functions, including determining cell shape, participating in cell division, and allowing cells to move. It also provides a tract-like system that directs the movement of organelles and other substances within the cells. Endoplasmic reticulum, ER. There are two types of ER, rough ER and smooth ER. This organelle helps process molecules created by the cell. The endoplasmic reticulum also transports these molecules to their specific destination either inside or outside the cell. Rough ER is covered with ribosomes that give it a rough appearance. Rough ER transports material through the cell. Smooth ER also transports material through the cell, but it contains enzymes which produces and digests lipids, that is fats, and membrane proteins. It detoxifies drugs and poisons present in the liver. Golgi apparatus, a flattened, layered, sac-like organelle that looks like a stack of pancakes. It is also called Golgi apparatus or Golgi complex. The Golgi apparatus packages molecules processed by the endoplasmic reticulum to be transported out of the cell. It is located near the nucleus. It produces the membranes that surround the lysosomes. The Golgi body packages proteins and carbohydrates into the membrane-bound vesicles for export from the cell. Lysosomes and peroxisomes. These organelles are the recycling center of the cell. They digest foreign bacteria that invade the cell, rid the cell of toxic substances, and recycle worn-out cell components. These are single membrane, oval, or spherical cellular organelles. They are also called as microbodies. They contain catalyzed enzymes. Peroxisomes are involved in the oxidation of long-chain fatty acids and synthesis of plasmalogans and glycolipids. Mitochondria, spherical to rod-shaped organelles with a double membrane. The inner membrane is enfolded many times, forming a series of projections. Mitochondria are complex organelles that convert energy from food into a form that the cell can use. They have their own genetic material, separate from the DNA in the nucleus, and can make copies of themselves. Nucleus serves as the cell's command center, sending direction to the cell to grow, mature, divide, or die. It also houses DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, the cell's hereditary material. The nucleus is surrounded by a membrane called a nuclear envelope, which protects the DNA and separates the nucleus from the rest of the cell. Plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is the outer lining of the cell. It separates the cell from its environment and allows material to enter and leave the cell. Ribosomes. Ribosomes are organelles that process the cell's genetic instructions to create proteins. These organelles can float freely in the cytoplasm to be connected to the endoplasmic reticulum. Ribosome size is measured in Swedberg S units. Next is nuclear membrane. The nuclear membrane is a double-layered structure surrounding the nucleus containing many nuclear pores. These pores allow different materials to leave, to move in or and out of the nucleus. Nucleolus. The nucleolus is present within the nucleus. Some cells have more than one nucleolus. It is the assembly plant for ribosomes. Ribosomal proteins are made in cytoplasm and transported back into the nucleus. Centrosome, a small body located near the nucleus called a microtubule organizing center. It has a dense center and radiating tubules. The centrosomes are where the microtubules are made. During cell division, the centrosome divides and two parts move to opposite sides of the dividing cell. The centriole is the dense center of the centrosome. Vacuole. It is a fluid-filled membrane surrounded cavities inside a cell. The vacuole fills with the food being digested and waste material is on its way out of the cell. There are specialized vacuoles which functions to store fat as fat droplets. Microtubules have the largest diameter among the fibers found in the cytoplasm of all eukaryotes. It involves many structures, cilia, flagella, spindle fibers that polymerize from centrioles during mitosis and meiosis. They are made up of the protein called tubulin and polymerizes into hollow tubules of 25 nanometer diameter. Cilia and flagella, they are organelles of locomotion. Both of them contain 9 double rings of microtubules, 2 central microtubules and 2 motor proteins, which allow motion along microtubules. Next is intracellular junctions. In intracellular junctions, multicellular organisms, adjacent cells are held together by several types of specialized junctions. The first one is tight junctions. Specialized belts that bind two cells tightly to each other prevent fluid from leaking into intracellular space. Desmosomes. Intracellular rivets that create tight bonds between the cells but allow fluids to pass through intracellular spaces. Gap junctions. Formed by two connecting protein rings embedded in a cell membrane of adjacent cells, allows passage of water, small solutes, but not protein and nucleic acids. Here I have shown you in this slide listed out the organelles, their structures and functions for your reference. Even in this slide, I have shown you the diagrams, the human cell components and their functions. Thank you, students.